had a dream, mother went to heaven, that's for real. Had the youngest singing, giving praise, thanks to him. I saw the party for real, had the glory you need. So what you said, hope, hope, heaven is holy. The man of old, in the crowns of gold. All chilling or feeling, riding the lots on throne. No wonder said, boy, come up. I woke up from sleep, only to see two black birds sitting on the wall.
Now there were two little black birds sitting on the wall.
I stand here for the motion that the government policies should play a significant role in encouraging bush burning. First, I'd like to tell us that the government policies should be made in such a way that scholarships are granted to some of our technical students in our county today. Take for example our students of GPC and GPHS. If you are there to see what these students are capable of doing on their opening door days, then you realize that if we had these industries in Cameroon to produce some of the things that we do not have here, I will tell you that our country will be one of the others we know. Now, this policy should be made to grant this scholarship to these students. So when they go out in countries, for example, like Japan, they gain this expertise and bring it back in Cameroon. Hence, I will tell you that in future we shall have industries in Cameroon. Secondly, these policies should also be made in such a way that assets are given to our commercial students, business management students, so that when they go out in countries like the USA, in countries like Germany, they will gain this expertise and bring them back into Cameroon here, wherein we shall have a proper management of our state finance. Hence, in future, we shall have balanced development. Thirdly, I would like us to know that these policies should be made in such a way that now we have the BMG, the bachelor's master's doctorate in Cameroon, but yet we do not yet have a future guarantee that this system is going to be that successfully effective. Now, this policy should be made in such a way that we give access to some of our lecturers, some of our tutors in the county to go out in counties like Britain, counties like America, who were already practicing this system right up to this date, to gain the expertise there and bring it back in Cameroon. And I will tell you that our educational system in Cameroon in future shall be modernized and will be very perfect. And again, our government policies should be made in such a way that they will create diplomatic ties with other countries, with other powerful countries today. Powerful countries in industrialization. Take for example, Japan. Our embassy in Japan today is not that functioning. If the government policies can be made in such a way that this embassy is modernized, so that our Cameroonians through the embassy will get expertise in the Japan, and they'll tell you in Cameroon today and in the...
I had a dream, mother went to heaven, that's for real. Had the youngest singing, giving praise, thanks to him. I saw the party for real, had the glory you need, so what you said, hope.
I already explained to you the reason why we are here, and that's to oppose the motion that government policies should not encourage bush falling. My colleague on the other side of the aisle has successfully mingled around with words, and not saying nothing. I'm impressed to see that you use one and two synonyms to lighten more than three or four points. You said scholarships are granted to students. Should I remind you that scholarship leads to brain drain? I don't need to remind you what my colleague has already said. You said access should be given to students of the accounting domain to study in America. That still leads to brain drain, please. You said once of the other we know. Which other do we know? Which country are you talking about? You refer to a country we don't know. Let's be precise, please. I would not like us to repeat points, Mr. the moderator, but let me begin by revealing certain statistics to you, which will go a long way to portray the standards of bush falling and to merit what every right-thinking government should do to its citizens in order to encourage them and have a good standard. Look at Equatorial Guinea, 2 years back, marked the highest economic growth rate. This is because they relied on their development in order to make them successful. Look at Libya in the 80s, received an economic embargo, restricting them from trading internationally with other countries. Yet, today, they are economic giants in Africa. I want us to look at the case of Ghana. Ghana is a country in the 70% of her population was involved, and 70% of her population had a certificate. Why? Because they were highly educated, and because of this education, the government could not employ all the people who were who were satisfied by the country. So they had to send them out. Sending them out is making them fall bush. And this bush ruins the country's economy, because the majority of the people who went out of the country were the active population, ranging from 18 to 35, as my colleague mentioned. Mr. Moderator, I don't know if my colleagues are very much aware about this aspect of capital flight, which is ruining our country drastically. Look at people of top government, people of top government positions. They take our money from our state coffers, embezzle or store in other state banks, which leads to a ruin in our economic facilities. Dear colleagues, I would not like you to put on this defeated attitude. Africa is the mother of civilization and remains the mother of civilization. No matter how the white man may try to take our mentalities away, thereby carrying our most intelligent students over to develop their country, we still men remain the mother of civilization. Mr. Moderator, I think with this, my colleague on the opposite side will agree with me that government policies should not encourage Bush.
I had a dream, mother went to heaven, that's for real. Had the youngest singing, giving praise, thanks to him. I saw the party for real, had the glory in me, so what you said.